It's October 31, and today in Philippine history, Evelio Javier was born in 1942 in Hamtik, Antique. He was born to attorney Everardo Javier, a prosecutor, and a teacher, Felisa Bellaflor. Evelio studied high school, got his BA in History and Government, and got his Bachelor of Laws at the Ateneo de Manila. He passed the bar in 1968 before becoming a law professor, building his law practice, and becoming a politician. Evelio married Precious Bello Lotilia in Manila in 1968 and they had two sons. Evelio became governor of Antique in 1971 at the age of 28. He was the face of youth in politics. In 1981, he worked for his master's in public administration from the John F. Kennedy School of Government at Harvard University. In 1984, Evelio ran for Congress and lost against Arturo Pacificador, a member of the Kilusang Bagong Lipunan. The animosity was so intense that at least seven of Javier's supporters were killed during the campaign. With violence and massive election fraud, Evelio filed an electoral protest with the Supreme Court. In 1986, Evelio became a campaign director for Cory Aquino in Antique. At the height of the campaign, masked gunmen opened fire on the former governor as he stood in front of the Capitol building while he was on a vigil to protect the election ballots. The Seattle Times reported that year, based on the ledgers discovered after the People Power Revolution, Pacificador received 1 million pesos from the Marcoses days after the assassination. Two cases involving Evelio Javier continued even after his death. The first was the election protest, which he won posthumously in 1986. The second is the case against Marcos crony Arturo Pacificador. Pacificador was acquitted in 2004, but the co-accused were sentenced. The Marcos-Pacificador connection remains strong with President Marcos Jr. filming a tribute to Turin Pacificador just last year that seems to be disconnected with his legacy.
As you come together to remember his legacy, may you seek inspiration from his compassion, generosity, and humility. May you also learn from his noble actions and live with a heart for service. Together, let us emulate Assemblyman Pacificador's example and strive to create a more inclusive, compassionate, and nurturing society.
Turing's nephews continue to serve in the local government and remain staunch Marcos supporters. In 2022, during the presidential campaign, the people of Antique refused to have a BBM rally happen at the Evelio Javier Freedom Park for obvious reasons. Turing Pacificador was the grandson of General Leandro Fulion, who was a member of the Katipunan and fought both the Spanish and the Americans. He later became the first Filipino governor of Antique. Evelio's assassination was among the triggers that inspired the ouster of the Marcos family in 1986. His name appears with other human rights violations victims at the Bantayog ng mga Bayani. Evelio's brother Ezequiel Javier and his nephew Paulo Javier also entered politics and served in the provincial government and in Congress. The younger Javier is running for governor in 2025. February 11, the day of Evelio's assassination, is now a special non-working public holiday in the island of Panay, including Antique, Aklan, Capiz, and Iloilo. A freedom park and an airport in Antique are named after him. Evelio Javier's legacy reminds us that courage can ignite change, more so in the face of oppression. Tandaan natin na kailangan natin ng mga leader na pinaglalaban tayo. Deserve natin yun. O diba?
Meow meow.